Everything is cool. Everything's okay. Just before last Christmas, my baby went away. Across the sea to an island where the bridge is brightly burned. So far away from my land, the valley of the unconcerned. I was walking down the road, man, looking at my shoes, when God sent me an angel just to chase away my blues. I saw 100,000 blackbirds, and they was flying through the sky. They seemed to form a teardrop from a black-haired angel's eye. That tear fell all around me and washed my sins away. Now everything is cool, everything's okay. Everything's cool, everything's okay. Just before last Christmas, my baby went away. I find it so surprising for myself to hear me say that everything is cool, everything's okay. Everything is cool, everything's okay. Why was just before last Christmas my baby went away? Wine-haired baby in 1951. The father was a stranger was the son. Call that child James Lewis, call these rooms a home. Changing all them diapers, polish all that crumb. Come on, baby, spend the night with me. Around the schoolyard, playing all the games, running, laughing, back and forth, a kid with two first names. A stranger in the closet, a life to die away. The past is running faster, singing harmony. Come on, baby, spend the night with me. God bless this kitchen, said the knick-knack shelf. Dinner's almost ready, go and wash yourself. Jimmy's growing up now, Wanda's growing old. The days are growing shorter, the nights are long and cold. Come on, baby, spend the night with me. On the 6 o'clock news, his brains were on the sidewalk, blood was on his shoes. Come on, baby, spend the night with me. Come on, baby, spend the night with me. Come on, baby, spend the night with me. I haven't sat down and sang since my early folky days. I usually like prefer standing up so I can run it at any juncture, you know. But I'm getting used to this. My leg just screwed up for a couple of weeks, and that's what they say. I'll give it a couple of weeks and I saw it out, but it ain't any good by then. Just kidding. We put a new record out last year called The Tree of Forgiveness. The only reason I put it out is because my wife and my son asked me to put a record out. I thought I'd just put one out a couple of years ago, but it's been 13 years. Willie Nelson says, my time gets away, you know? Anyway, the damn thing took off and sold a bunch of records. I don't know why. All right, thanks, man. Anyhow, we're trying our best to keep up with the record. So we're gonna sing a bunch of songs off the new record and a bunch of old songs. And we ain't going nowhere, so you ain't going nowhere. All right. We're knocking on your screen door, ain't we, Kevin? I ain't got nobody, I ain't around my doorstep. Ain't got no loose chain, I ain't around my jeans. If you see somebody, would you send them over my way? I could use some help here, but can't afford it, man. I was at a family, but they up and left me. Nothing but a leg track, another side of George Jones. I was in a high cot, banging on my six string, kicking at the trash can, walking scared bones. I can see your backbone, if I close my eyes now. I can hear the train tracks, too lonely on the line. I'm playing an inch of business, but you ain't got the answer. I'm knocking on your screen door, in the summertime. Here we go. Oh, breeze now, swinging in the breeze now, just hanging on the vine. I'm dreaming about a sailboat, I don't need a fur coat. Underneath the dashboard, got some sweet potato wine. I can see your back porch, if I close my eyes now. I can hear the train tracks to the lonely old land. I'm thinking it's your business, but you ain't got the answer. I'm knocking on your screen door in the summertime. I'm knocking on your screen door in the summertime.
Thank you.
This is an old song here. I was like this one. I named the record after it. It actually had two names to it. It was called Chain of Sorrow, and it was called Bruised Orange. In the ash house, come here, oh, come back. Like a long ago Sunday, when I walked through the alley on a cold winter's morning to a church house just to shovel some snow. I heard sirens on the train tracks, how naked, getting neuter. And all the boys been hit by a local commuter just from walking with his back turned to a train that was coming so slow. You can gaze out the window, get mad and get madder. Throw your hands in the air, say what does it matter. But it don't do no good to get angry, say of me I know. For a heart stained in anger, grows weak and grows bitter. You'll become your own prisoner as you watch yourself sit there wrapped up in a trap. Very own chain of sorrow. Come your own watch yourself sit there, have never dreamed of your very own chain of sorrow. I want to dedicate this next song, where I had this guitar player with me in Nashville, Tennessee for about 7 years. He was from County Tipperary in Ireland, and his name was Philip Donnelly. They called him the Clontarf Cowboy. His Clontarf is where he was originally from. And he first came over to America with Donovan in the 70s and played with him. And I met Philip in the early 80s in Nashville, Tennessee, over at Cowboy Jack Clement's house. And we become fast buddies, and we became outlaws on the road together, you know. We had several other things we were doing on the road just to keep ourselves sane. Like, we were looking for the perfect pint of Guinness in America. This was back in the 80s when they just didn't know what they were doing with a pint of Guinness then, over in America at least. They didn't know how to pull the damn thing, you know. They'd pull it flat and it tastes too sweet, and amongst other things. There's a lot to bitch about, you know. But Philip used to carry little pocket screwdrivers in his upper left pocket. And we'd talk to the barman, and he'd ask about the pint because he'd hear Philip's accent. And Philip would go, you know, he says, a little too much gas in there. He goes, would you mind if I got behind the bar? So Philip would be on his back under the bar adjusting the things. And everybody would get a better pint, and we'd get free pints all the time. So he was much more than a great blues guitar player. He recorded this song with me, and he recorded this with our good friend Nancy Griffith. And also, when Philip went back over to Ireland in the late 80s to look after his mother after his father passed away, he recorded this and had a hit with it locally in Ireland. This is the Speed and the Sound of Loneliness. Jason, I believe you're going to give us a little taste of Philip Donnelly, aren't you?
I'll do my best.
All right. You come home late and you come home early. You come home big when you're feeling small. You come home straight and you come home curly. Sometimes you don't come home at all. When the world's come over you, and when in heaven's name may have you down, you've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. I got a heart that burns with a fever. I got a worried and a jealous mind. How can love last forever? Getting left so far behind. When the words come over you, when in heaven's name have you done? You've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. Administration back in Washington, D.C. And that's about all I want to say about it, because otherwise I'll start using some really shitty words. This is for that asshole in the White House. We got some genuine Ukrainian film. The dark and distant drumming, the pounding of the hooves, the silence of everything that moves. Late at night, you see them decked out in shining jewels, the coming of the caravan of fools. Like the wings of a dove, the waiter's white glove seemed to shimmer by the light of the pool. Some dark blinding winter, when you can't help but lose, you're running with the caravan of fools. Caravan of fools, caravan of fools, you're running with the caravan of fools. Love and devotion, deep as any ocean, don't play by anybody's rules. But with your carousel of horses, your unforeseen forces, you're running with the caravan of fools. The caravan of fools, caravan of fools, you're running with the caravan of fools. Twice a year, whether my wife wants me to go or not. I think maybe she's getting wise to what these fishing trips are really about, because the last thing she says to me is, going out the doors, don't forget your fishing pole. Me and my buddies, we know what to do, though. We don't care if the fish are biting or not. We, just throw a couple of cases of ice cold beer in the boat. We motor up the river for about an hour and a half, cut the engine off, float down the river, and tell each other lies all day. Fortunately, I got a really good fishing buddy that's full of that stuff. Me and him, we was floating down the White River in Arkansas one Thursday afternoon. We were fishing for rainbow trout. And we didn't know it, but all the rainbow trout had gone to Fort Worth, Texas for the weekend. There was some kind of worm convention going on there. And my buddy's in the back of the boat, barely hanging onto his fishing pole. And he says to me, he says, I remember Thursdays back in Nebraska when I was growing up. He said that me and my buddies used to go down to the railroad rink, because Thursday night, that was the night the egg farmers came to town. He said, and they dropped their daughters off at the railroad rink, and they go into town and sell all their eggs. He said, and we'd make time with the country girls. He said, we used to refer to Thursday nights as egg and daughter night. I said, hold it, man, you don't know it, but you are writing a song while you're talking right now. So I went back to Nashville and I got my favorite co-writer, Pat McLaughlin. Pat used to play with us and dance all over the stage with his mandolin. And I said, Pat, listen to this story. So I told him the same story I just told you. And Pat and me, we wrote this song in less time than it takes to sing it. As you can tell, it takes longer to tell the story. So we put a name on the song because we recorded it. We called it Egg and Daughter Night, Lincoln, Nebraska, 1967. So I called up my fishing buddy. I said, John Earl, you'll never guess what we did.
I said, we wrote a song about your egg and daughter story night. And I said, we called it Egg and Daughter Night, Lincoln, Nebraska, 1967. He said, Lincoln? Why would I want to go to Lincoln? I'm from Norfolk, Nebraska. I said, well, maybe because it rhymes with some of the best lines in the song. You too. If you like your apple sweet and your streets are not concrete, you'll be in your bed by nine every night. Take your hand-spanked corn-fed gal and your best friend's four-eyed pal to a treat right down the street that's dynamite. Let your conscience be your guide if you put your foot inside. You wish you left you well enough alone, but when you got hell to pay, put the truth on layaway and blame it on that old crazy bone. Crazy bone,
crazy bone,
crazy bone,
crazy bone.
Well, you wish you left you well enough alone, but when you got hell to pay, put the truth on layaway and blame it on that old crazy bone. But don't be stuck up in Alaska when you should be in Nebraska on a Thursday when it's egg and daughter night. When the farmers come to town and they spread them eggs around and they drop their daughters down at the roller rink. Well, you're probably standing there with your slick back, real cream hair. You're lucky he's in, your daddy's fine tooth comb. If he knew what you was thinking, they'd run you out of Lincoln. Just blame it on that old crazy bone. Crazy bone.
Crazy bone.
Crazy bone.
Crazy bone.
Well, you must have left that wisdom to that home. If he knew what you was thinking, they'd run you out of Lincoln. Just blame it on that old crazy bone. Here comes that crazy bone. Ski-da-da-ba-boo-da-boo. 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 Yeah-ba-boo-da-boo. Ski-da-ba-boo-da-boo. When your grandkids all are grown and they put you in a home and eternity is approaching fast, yeah, you're half out of your head and you probably pissed the bed and you can't see a thing to save your posterior. When you fire across the prairie in a local cemetery, they already got your name carved out in stone. But when all them nurses say, Grandpa, why you walk that way? Just blame it on that old crazy bone. And everybody in that old folks home, yeah, blame it on that old crazy bone. Crazy bone. Thank you. I promise no more stories that are longer than the song. This song here is unusual for me in that everything in this song is true. I mean, it just happened that it rhymed. Years ago, I was real close to my grandpa and my grandma on my father's side. And one day, this was after I became a songwriter for a living, I was thinking about them. They were really on my mind that day. So I took a piece of paper and I just wrote down every vivid image I could remember of them because they were sweet people. And I noticed when I got done that the 17th line rhymed with the 11th one, and the second one with the 23rd one. I just rearranged them and they became a song. I did make the mistake, though, of debuting this song at my family reunion, where some of my grandfather's sisters were still alive. And I got all done with it, and they were sitting there with their arms crossed like this, and their glasses on the end of their nose, looking at me. And I said, well, what'd you think? And they said, he didn't smoke Camel cigarettes. And your grandma didn't go to Bowling Green. I said, you mean that's it? That was 2 out of 400. Okay, now you know the truth. Grandpa wore a suit to dinner nearly every day. No particular reason, he just dressed that way. Round neck tie and a badge of best. Both his wingtip shoes. Built the closet on our back porch. He put a penny in a burned out pen. Grandpa was a carpenter. The houses, stores, and banks. Changed from Camel cigarettes. Hammered nails and planks. He was level on the level. Shaved even every door. Put in fries and hammer. Oh, Lincoln won the war. Take me with him to stained glass in every window. Three days in every day. Grandpa was a carpenter. Did the houses, stores, and banks. Changed smoking little cigarettes. Hammered nails and planks. He was level on the level. Shaved even every door. Ported for eyes and hair. No Lincoln won the war. Songwriter. Otherwise, I'd be retired. Notice how that makes the musicians laugh when you say retired. I believe what happened with this song is I was still kind of learning some guitar chords. I mean, I learned a bunch of Carter Family songs initially from my brother Dave, because he wanted me to play a rhythm while he was playing fiddle. He gave me a couple of Carter Family records, and I fell in love with their stories. And also the idea they just used three chords for a song unless somebody was gonna die, then they put a minor chord in just to kind of warn you. I thought that was pretty good. They should have that in life as well. Have a minor chord a couple of days before there's a death in the family. Anyway, somebody taught me something like nobody knows you when you're down and out or something. Some of it had a whole lot of guitar chords in it. And I used it as an exercise. I'd just see how fast I could go through those guitar chords and still play my guitar. And after I learned something like that, I thought, the next song I write, I'm gonna put every chord, guitar chord I know in the song. And they just happen to fall in the right order. This is hello in there. Thank you. We had an apartment in the city. Woo! Me and the red light living there. Well, it'd been years since the kids had grown a life of their own and left us alone. John and Linda live in Omaha. And Joe is somewhere on the road. And we lost Navy in the Korean War. Now I still don't know what for. It don't matter anymore. You know that old trees just grow stronger. Old rivers grow wilder every day. Old people just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello in there, hello. Hello. Yeah. So if you're walking down the street sometime and spot some hollow ancient eyes, well, please don't just pass them by and stare as if you didn't care. Say hello in there. Hello. Hello in there. Anybody home? Acoustic guitar and harmonica. He's been with me almost 25 years. He's a fine songwriter himself from Bloomington, Indiana. That's Mr. Jason Wilbur. This gentleman over here playing the fiddle, the pedal steel, the mandolin and electric guitar. He joined the band last year. If he hadn't joined the band, we'd have a big hole in it. He's currently living over in East Nashville, Tennessee. That's Mr. Fats Kaplan. Back here on the drums, I went for a long time without a drummer. I stopped into a little club one night in Nashville with a couple of my buddies was singing their songs, and they asked me to get up and sing a few of mine. I sang three or four of my songs. This fella played drums on them. I turned around and thought, man, I gotta have some of that on the road with me. I share him with great singer-songwriter John Hyatt. And that's Mr. Kenneth Blevins on the drum. The only other musician on the stage that will sit down with me. Down here on the end, this fellow's been with me 26 years. Golden years, too, Dave. They've been golden. He joined the Lost Dogs and Mixed Blessings band. And he hadn't given it up yet. For my money, he's the finest bass player in the world. That's David Jakes on bass. This here is a song that I wrote for my wife, Fiona. Fiona's around here somewhere. If she hadn't run away from home yet. I figure if you're writing songs for 50 years and you're married, you better damn well write your wife a song. For you, Faith. I woke up this morning to a garbage truck. Looks like this old horseshoe's done ran out of luck. If I came home, or would you let me in? Fry me some pork chops and forgive my sin. Surround me with your boundless love. Confound me with your boundless love. I was drowning in a sea, lost as I could be, when you found me with your boundless love. Sometimes my old heart is like a washing machine. It bounces around till my soul comes clean. And when I'm clean and hung out to dry, I'm gonna make you laugh until you cry. Surround me with your boundless love. Confound me with your boundless love. I was drowning in a sea, lost as I could be, when you found me with your boundless love. Substitution. I was on my way back to the hotel, and just before I hopped into the elevator so I could get in the shower and eat my cheeseburger in the rain, I ran into a fella named Lars, and he said, "John Prine, would you sing this song for me?" And I said, "Yeah, well." So I called up Jason, and we took the other song off the song list, and we put this one in its place. So Lars, I hope you appreciate the trouble we went to. No, it's no trouble whatsoever. I love this song. It's one of my personal favorites. I wrote this song about the first girl that ever broke my heart. And man, if she had enough, I wouldn't have become a songwriter. Every songwriter you see, man, she's got a heart that's just busted up. Like it looks like an old clock radio with springs hanging out of it and shit. Band-aids all over it. It's our Medal of Honor. Ain't it time? Okay, Lars, this is Far From Me. As the cafe was closing, on a warm summer night, Kathy was cleaning the spoons. The radio played the hit parade. I hung along with the tune. She asked me to change the station. Said the song just drove her insane. But it weren't just the music you're playing. It was me she was trying to blame. And the sky's black and still now. Up on the hill, when the angels sang, in faint, our old broken bow looks just like a diamond ring. but it's far, far from me. Well, I leaned on my left leg in the parking lot dirt. And Kathy was closing the lights. A gin bug flew from the warmth it once knew. And I wished for once I were right. The old song, well, you know, she still laughs with me. But she waits for just a second too long. And the sky is black and still now. I'm only here when the angels sing. Ain't funny how an old broken bottle looks just like a diamond ring. But it's far, far from me. Probably the prettiest song off the Tree of Forgiveness. I love this one. It's kind of personal to me. It's called Summer's End. Summer's ends around the bend, just flying. The swimming suits are on the line, just drying. I'll meet you there for our conversation. I hope I didn't ruin your whole vacation. Well, you never know how far from home you're feeling. until you watch the shadows cross the ceiling. Well, I don't know, but I can see it snowing in your car. The windows are wide open. Come on home. Come on home. No, you don't have to be alone. Just come on home. Valentines break hearts and minds at random. That old Easter egg ain't got a leg to stand on. Well, I can see that you can't win for trying. And New Year's Eve is bound to leave you crying. Please come on home. Come on home. No, you don't have to be alone. Just come on. The moon and stars hang out in bars just talking. I still love that picture of us walking, just like that old house we thought was haunted. Summer's in, came faster than we wanted. Come on home, come on home. No, you don't have to be alone. Fiona and me went out to Los Angeles for the Grammys, and a year ago, me and Fiona went out there, and Pat McLaughlin was with me, because me and Pat wrote two of the songs off the Tree of Forgiveness that were nominated for Grammy songs, and me and Pat both took speeches. And we lost. And we took a speech out there for Summer's End and for Knocking on Your Screen Door. And they nominated me for Album of the Year, for Americana Album of the Year or something. And I lost that one too. So three strikes and I was out. You know, but I mean, we had a damn good year, so I really can't complain about that. But they invited me back this year. I guess they were only kicking dust in my eye. Now they told me to come on back. They wanted to give me a Lifetime Achievement Award for 50 years. After 50 years, I guess I better change the tires on that sucker. My old buddy, Bonnie Raitt, was good enough to come out there, and she sang Angel from Montgomery. And they gave me an award, and they can't have it back, so there. We were really chuffed to get that. That was pretty neat. Wait till the next 50 years, I'll really show my ass. This is Angel from Montgomery. I am an old woman named after my mother. My old man is another child that's grown old. If dreams were lightning and thunder were desire, this old house would have burnt down a long time ago. Make me an angel that flies from a company. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to believe in this living is just the hard way to go. When I was a young girl, I had me a cowboy. He weren't much to look at, or just a free rimmed man. But that was a long time, and no matter how I tried, the years just flow by like a broken down dam. Make me an angel to flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go. I'm no good at requests. They pre-programmed me before I come out of here. I think you can probably tell that. That's a good song, though. Maybe you should sing it later on. Is there ever enough space between us to keep us both honest and true? Why is it so hard just to sit in the yard and stare at the sky so blue? I got a new way of walking, a new way of talking, anyway I'm around you. But it gives me the blues when I got some good news and you're not there to bring it to. Life is a blessing, it's a delicatessen of all the little favors you do. All wrapped up together, no matter the weather, baby, you always come through. Well, it's a measure of treasure, it gives me the pleasure of loving you the way I do. And you know I would gladly say I need you look badly and bring these little things to you. Cause you got gold. Gold inside of you. You got gold. Gold inside of you. Well, I got some gold inside me too. Thinking I'm knowing, I gotta be going. You know I hate to stay so long. It gives me an ocean, a mix of emotion. I have to work it out in a song. Well, I'm leaving a lot for the little I got. You know a lot of little will do. And if you give me your love, I'll let it shine up above. Light my way back home to you. Cause you got gold. Gold inside of you. You got gold. Gold inside of you. Well, I got some gold inside me. You got wheels turning inside of you. You got wheels turning inside of you. Well, I got wheels turning inside me too. Club in Chicago. I was still delivering mail during the day, and they let me sing on Thursday nights for they charged 50 cents at the door, and I got a quarter of it. I haven't got the other quarter. Well, it was Sam, probably. Anyway, I'd sung there three Thursdays in a row. And I was on my mail route that day, and I was thinking I was going to sing that night. And I thought, well, the same 12 people are going to be there. I bet they're expecting a new song. So I wrote this song on the way down to the club. I made it up in the car. When I got down there, I took my Martin app. I went inside the men's room, and I stood in front of the mirror. I thought I'd written a song where, since I made the melody up without a guitar, I thought I'd written a song I couldn't play. I thought it had a bunch of jazz chords in it. So I stood in front of the mirror and I played the song. It was the same damn three chords I play on every song. I don't know what that goes to show you, but it goes to show you. This is 7 years. Turned to water. Christmas days have come and gone. Broken toys and faded colors are all that's left to linger on. I hate graveyards and old pawn shops, for they always bring me tears. Can't forgive the way they robbed me of my childhood souvenirs. Memories that can't be broken, that can't be won at carnivals for free. Well, it took me years to get those souvenirs, and I don't know how they slipped away from me. Broken hearts and dirty windows make life difficult to see. That's why last night and this morning always looked the same to me. And I hate reading old love letters, for they always bring me tears. I can't forgive the way they robbed me of my sweetheart's souvenirs. Memories that can't be broken, they can't be won at carnivals for free. Well, it took me years to get those souvenirs, and I don't know how they slipped away from me.
Thank you.
You bet. You're welcome. I know a guy that's got a lot to lose. He's a pretty nice fella, kind of confused. Got muscles in his head, ain't never been used. Thinks he owns half of this town. Started drinking heavy, got a big red nose. Beat his old lady with a rubber hose. And he took her out to dinner, bought her new clothes. It's the way that the world goes round. That's the way that the world goes round. Yep, one day, the next you down. It's a half an inch of water, you think you're gonna drown. That's the way that the world goes round. I was sitting in the bathtub, counting my toes when the radiator broke. Water all froze, I got stuck in the ice without my clothes, naked as the eyes of a clown. I was crying ice cubes, hoping I'd croak when the sun come through the window. The ice all broke, I stood up and laughed, thought it was a joke. It's the way that the world goes round. That's the way that the world goes round, yep, one day. The next you down, it's a half an inch of water. You think you're gonna drown. That's the way that the world goes round. That's the way that the world goes round. That's the way that the world goes round. That's the way the world goes round. Sending this for the fellow that drove me over here. I mean, might as well. I wouldn't be here if he hadn't drove me over here. Yorn, this is for you. You didn't think I was going to sing this. I bet you're just about to pee your pants. Okay, you're welcome. I hope this is the way I did it on the record. I don't know if it is or not. I mean, this is the way Bob Dylan did it. I heard Bob Dylan did this on YouTube. Different one, Korean. Thank you. People let her say it. Sometimes the world frowns. And people that are kings, sometimes they wear a crown. But all the people who don't fit, they get the only fun they get from people putting people down. People putting people down. People without love sometimes build a fence around. The garden up above that makes the whole world go round. But the people who don't fit, they get the only fun they get from people putting people down. People putting people down. So cold. Sometimes it gets so cold. You may lose your wife, you may lose your family, and you may lose your mind just to keep your sanity. But the people who don't fit, they get the only fun they get from people putting people down. People putting people down. People that are glad, sometimes they wear a smile. And people without dreams, they walk the extra mile. But the people who don't fit, they get the only fun they get from people putting people down. People putting people down. People putting people down. People putting people down. So cold. Sometimes it gets so cold. Folk music school across the street called the Old Town School of Folk Music. And they would teach you, they didn't try to teach you to read music, they would teach you two or three chords. They'd teach you an old folk song, or, you know, or at worst they'd teach you a Kingston Trio song. You know? And nothing wrong with Kingston Trio, but it was the people that listened to it. That was the one. They were the weirdos. But anyway, I used to go down there and have a beer and some after classes, and I learned a couple of bluegrass chords, and they said a couple of Carter Family songs, and I was on my way. I learned Elizabeth Cotton, and I could finger pick all of a sudden. So I started writing my own songs. And one night, I was at the same club. I wasn't working there. I was just a patron of the place. I had me a beer. It was an open stage night. That meant that anybody could get up on stage, and I mean anybody. So I was sitting there, and about the fourth or fifth person got up, and I kind of said under my breath, man, this really sucks. And somebody said, well, why don't you get up? So I had another beer, and I got up. And I sang three songs, and this was the first song I sang. When I got done singing this song, nobody applauded. They just looked at me, and I looked at them, and they looked at me, and I looked at them. And eventually one person started applauding, I think just to get out of the place. This is Sam Stone. Sam Stone came home to his wife and family after serving in the conflict overseas. And the time that he served has shattered all his nerves and left a little shrapnel in his name. But the morphine eased the pain, the grass grew around his brain, gave him all the confidence he lacked. with a purple heart and a monkey on his back. There's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. And Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone's welcome home didn't last too long. He went to work when he'd spent his last dime. And Sammy took to stealing when he got that empty feeling for $100 habit without overtime. And the gold rolled through his veins like 1,000 railroad trains. And eased his mind in the hours that he chose, while the kids ran around wearing other people's clothes. There's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. And Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have the years, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone was alone when he popped his last balloon, climbing walls while sitting in a chair. Well, he played his last request while the room smelled just like death, with an overdose hovering in the air. But life had lost its fun. There was nothing to be done but trade his house and then he borrowed the GI Bill for a flag train casket on a local hero's hill. There's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. And Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have the gears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios.
Who's leaving me?
many years ago, along the Illinois-Wisconsin border, there was this Indian tribe. They found two babies in the woods, white babies. One of them was named Elizabeth, and she was the fairer of the two, while the smaller and more fragile one was named Marie. Having never seen white girls before, and living on the two legs known as the twin legs, they named the larger and more beautiful leg Lake Elizabeth, and thus the smaller lake that was hidden from the highway became known forever as Lake Marie. Talking to this girl who was standing there with her back turned to Lake Marie. The wind was blowing, especially through her hair. There was four Italian sausages cooking on the outdoor grill. Man, oh man. He was sizzling. Many years later, we found ourselves up in Canada, trying to save our marriage and perhaps catch a few fish. Whatever came first. She fell asleep in my arms, humming the tune to Louie Louie. Ah, baby, woo, we are low now. Were shocking and the knocks were knocking. Practically everyone was there in the parking lot by the forest preserve. The police had found two bodies in the woods. Naked bodies. And their faces had been horribly disfigured by some kind of sharp object. I saw it on the news, you know, in a black and white video. You know what blood looks like in black and white, don't you? Shadows. Shadows. That's what it looks like. All the love we share between her and me, that is. Man, it was slam. Slammed up against the bank, so look, Mary, Mary.
Ginger ale, give her a smoke, cigarette, that's 9 miles long.
that pretty girl on the tilt to work. Cause this old man is going to town. And as God is my witness, I'm getting back into show business. I'm going to open a nightclub called The Tree of Forgiveness and forgive everybody ever done me any harm. Why, I might even invite a few choice critics. Those syphilitic parasitics. Buy my pint of Smithwick's and smother them with my charms. Cause I'm going to have a cocktail, vodka and ginger ale. Get a good smoke cigarette, 9 miles long. More kiss that pretty girl on the tilt to work. Cause this old man is going to town. Let's go to town, boys. Yeah, whiskey to die, but you could do. Yeah, yeah, when I get to heaven, I'm gonna take this wristwatch off of my arm. What are you gonna do with time after you bought the farm? Thanks, I knew you were there. Then I'm gonna look up my mom and dad. And good old brother Doug, well, I bet him and cousin Jackie are still cutting up a rug. And I wanna see all my mama's sisters, cause that's where all the love starts. Man, I miss them all like crazy. Bless their little hearts. And I always will remember these words my daddy said. He said, buddy, when you're dead, you're a dead peckerhead. I hope to prove him wrong. That is, when I get to heaven. Cause I'm gonna have a cocktail, vodka and ginger ale. Yeah, I'm gonna smoke a cigarette that's 9 miles long. I'm gonna kiss that pretty girl on the tilt to work. Cause this old man is going into town. Let's go to town, boys. Yeah, guests up here this evening, last song of the night with us. I want Ian Noe to come back out. Ian, come on out and sing with us. Okay. Hey, Tom Russell here. I heard you was here, Tom. If you're here, come out, come out. If not, stay in, stay in. All right. Fiona, you gonna come out and sing with us? You and Martina? My wife Fiona's gonna come out. It's the only way to get me off the stage. And Martina, you coming out? All right. You gotta come up pretty good, I'll see. Somebody told me a fib then. All right. This is a song I wrote for my father Bill Prine. I was in the, away in the army, and actually I was in Germany in 1967, and he sent me a letter telling me that the Peabody Coal Company had tore down his family in the town he was born in, Paradise, Kentucky. And he wrote, sent me a little clipping from the newspaper. So I was just starting to write songs, and I wanted my dad to know that I was a songwriter. He always wanted me to sing Hank Williams songs for him, which I loved singing. But I wanted him to know that his son was a songwriter. So I put him in the song, and I knew he'd listen to it. So then he knew I was a songwriter. So we're all gonna sing that song for you. And I want to add one little note to it. I found out driving over here that Joe Hill's from this town. Yeah. I'm Joe Hill. My dad was a union organizer in the Steelworkers Union. He raised all four of his boys to always pay attention to the union, and the unions are going away these days, so you gotta pay more attention than ever to them. When I was a child, my family would travel down to Western Kentucky, where my parents were born. There's a backwards old town that's often remembered so many times that my memories are worn. Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where Paradise lay? I'm sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train's holding it away. I better fast. Drums. gathered my ashes, put down the Green River, and let my soul roll on up to the Rochester name. I'll be halfway to heaven with paradise waiting, just 5 miles away from wherever I am. Down by the Green River where paradise lay. I'm sorry, my son, but you're too late and ask Mr. Peabody's gold train, how did it away? Mr. Peabody's gold train, how did it away? Mr. Peabody's gold train, how did it away? Thank you so much for coming out to see us tonight. Thanks for our special guest, Ian Miller. Our special duo guest, Martina and Fiona Reeder. Jason Wooden on the guitar. That's Captain on the steel. Taylor Chase on bass. Taylor Bennett on the drum. I'm Johnny Pratt. Thanks a million. We appreciate it.